top of the action, we don't know.
That should be it.
My bands get more like Volvo. Your best stuff looks like my words. Synapses fire and
D2 is heading to Paris.
At what parts does esports beat regular sports? Well, in 2017, I wrote an article for The Next Web about exactly this subject. And I think a lot has to do with them constantly evolving. So, almost 3 years later, let's see where we stand. We will look at the top grossing and most impactful esports games, their impact on society, what we can learn from them, and what is possibly ahead. So, a few brief spoilers. It has to do with their fluidity of thinking, their open-mindedness, and their business model innovation. So without further ado, let's see what we can learn from esports and gaming. Fortnite has around 350 million registered users. They've got 78 million monthly active users, and their 2019 championship amassed 2.3 million viewers. And they had a 30 million prize pool, which you might have heard of. Now, if we look at Fortnite, this is what people are watching during an esports tournament.
Right on the edge of the zone, the shockwave into the air, and he's gonna drop on down to height for the moment. The spray coming on in, it's not enough.
And then imagine that during the tournament, this colorful lad walks onto the stage. And please pay close attention to what he says.
Competitive Fortnite isn't going anywhere. Once season 9 wraps up and we move into our next season, we'll be debuting the Fortnite Championship Series. This will give players a chance to compete against the best of the best, where every single result matters, with a leaderboard to track results over the course of the season. Follow your favorite players on their quest to become the first season champions with millions of dollars at stake. Now, this is just a taste of what's to come as we also plan on stepping up our competitive efforts across the board. So keep your eyes peeled for more news as you root on your favorite competitors in the back half of the matches. Golden Boy, Monster, back to you, gentlemen.
Now, can you imagine this happening during a UEFA Championship League? That the representative of the company walks up on the field and says, "Hey, so this match is still going on, but we're also going to launch a different tournament with a new field, with a vertical field, with different players, different rules, everything is going to be different." It's almost totally unimaginable. But with gaming, it is, because they keep on evolving, they keep on experimenting, they keep on finding new and more product market fits. And I find that very, very intriguing. At the same time, I think we should look at gaming in a broader sense. Because it's not just a game, it's not just a sport, it's not just a social gathering. For some, maybe it's even larger than life. So you can see that it's larger than life during this Travis Scott concert.
Sun is down. Freezing cold! That's how we already know. It is here. My dog will probably do it for Louis Bell.
That's wild.
That's just all he know, he don't know nothing.
Great!
Dude! Oh my god!
Yeah. Oh,
yeah.
Oh my.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh! Oh my god! Oh my! Make this here with all the ice on in the booth at the gate outside. Bro, when they pull up, they give me loose. Yo, you know Travis loves this shit. It's his other skin, it's his other skin. Yo, is he gonna transition into the other one?
Oh my, wait. We just got like a mini map now.
And the maps that you play, they constantly change, which brings a lot of amazement and joy for the players.
Let me out. Oh, yo, if you don't land the agency or Risky Reels or Salty Springs, your game's over for a little bit. What happens if we go in? I'm going straight in, boys. Let's go. I might be distracted from like a main plot, but I'm going in the water. Oh, it's literally like a water storm. Wait, hold on, get me out. It hurts. Does the water come in? Yo, this is... I was not expecting...
So it's more creative, it's more fluid, and it's always changing.
Yeah, just working, man. Just, you know, just trying to catch the vibes. I was in Toronto for like a minute, so I just, I had to come out here for something. I just decided to, stay and work out here for a bit.
You can play the same game the pros are playing. You can hang out with your friends or with Drake, if Drake is your friend. As Lego Venture says, Fortnite is taking the first credible step at making the first metaverse, where people can play and watch and share and socialize together. There will be others. We want to invest in them. That's what Lego Venture says. Well, of course you do, you know. Everyone does. And at the same time, A16Z says that games are the new mall and the new sports bar. Games are the next social network. Fortnite looks more like Facebook than it does a traditional shooter game. Millions of players socialize in squads and custom games, yada yada yada, you get the idea. And Netflix says, we compete with and lose to Fortnite more than HBO. This is from their shareholder letter from the fourth quarter 2019. So I think that, you know, you compete on eyeballs, you compete on attention, and if gaming is more alluring and more interesting than movies or than series, then okay, then you'll just lose. And at the same time, streamers, they are production powerhouses. Let's look at, for an example, at Dr. Disrespect. Now these people, when you start out as an autonomous person, as an individual, and you move up through the ranks and you amass your following, and you only have like a small team of a producer, someone doing your social, someone doing your editor, maybe you have a team of like 3 or 4 people. So you've got a lot of autonomy where you can do almost like whatever you want. And that's what you see a lot with these streamers. So let's look at an example of Dr. Disrespect.
But I still there. Yeah, this guy.
Is that a 2-for-1?
Not clear.
Is it? Are you sure?
God, today's gonna be a good one.
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, downstairs inside of the arena, we're doing a 2-for-1. What is it? Buttered ass popcorn with lots of sodium on it. You can buy 2 bags for 1.
Now, if you look at the heroes and icons in esports in comparison to the ones in regular sports, there is a slight difference in how they portray themselves. Although Tyson Fury is still very relatable because he was so open to share his battle with depression, I think what makes the esports icons relatable is their geekiness and weirdness, which might hit closer to home for their following. At the same time, if you look at the esporter and streamer Ninja, his avatar is available as a skin in Fortnite to play as. And if you have a virtual avatar, you can let this avatar go on journeys. Put them in different situations. Even have them make music. Or dress them up in Louis Vuitton skins. And then, during a tournament, you can have physical representations of the virtual avatars do a performance as an opening act. Are you still there? What a merger of realities. So, you've been looking at the opening performance of the League of Legends tournament. More on the other top grossing esports games, League of Legends, Dota 2 and Counter-Strike in the next part. But also the impact of COVID-19 on esports and what I see that gaming can do for creativity.